Just shortly after the release of the version 2025.1, Twinmotion surprises everyone with a new update, version 2025.1.1. Stay until the end of the video because I have a special surprise for you. But now let's dive straight into all new functionalities. 1. 3D grass. Many people have been asking for it, and finally it has arrived. The new grass material will allow you to speed up the process of scattering a dense and luxurious lawn of your scene in no time. Like any other material, select it from the Twinmotion library, apply it to any surface, and instantly it will be fully characterized with 3D grass. One of the main aspects is that it does not have the same weight as the scatter and paint commands, so you can also cover infinite surface areas and notice how Twinmotion continues to perform at its best. Additionally, say goodbye to grass layer cutoff due to calculation limits. Now you can render the grass layer without worrying about hiding the cut parts with other 3D models. The most important thing, however, is its ease of use. Choose from 5 available types, adjust the size with sliders, control the amount of fuzziness, and create realistic effects just by applying 2 different shades of color. 2. Clay material. Mainly addressed to the automotive industry, 10 new clay materials have been added to the material modeling library. There are different types and colors, and personally, I think they can also be used in the architectural world, both as plastic materials and as furniture covering materials. 3. Modeling tools. The modeling menu is growing. Now it is possible to separate or merge meshes, and it's fantastic. Any imported object can now be separated either based on the groups in which it was modeled or based on the materials. This is great because it allows complete customization of 3D models imported into Twinmotion, assigning materials to individual parts of the model and creating customizations that would be impossible to manage without freeform 3D modeling software. Once the meshes are separated, merge them into a single selection with the merge command. Also amazing. Thanks to these commands, you can fully customize all the 3D models available in my library. I'll leave you the link in the description in case you haven't downloaded it yet. 4. Transform panel coordinates. The XYZ menu has undergone some slightly modifications. It is now possible to have objects transfer information in the world or relative coordinates, allowing more flexibility. It is now possible to copy transform values, such as position, rotation, and scale, and paste them onto another object. Finally, the value fields on the transform panel now allow the entry of expressions like additions and multiplications. 5. Unit system. Millimeters mode. The Edit Preference menu has a new entry for setting millimeters as units. Using this value will also set the transform panel in millimeters. 6. Camera Inertia. A new camera inertia setting is now available in the Preference panel. This option enables smoother, more fluid navigation in the viewport by adding gradual acceleration and deceleration to camera movements. Edit Pivot Tools. The icons for modifying the pivot have been slightly changed, and now there are several new operations to adjust its position. However, the most important and revolutionary one for me is the center pivot down option, which, with one click, positions the pivot of a 3D object at the base of its bounding box. How many times have you imported a 3D model into Twinmotion from the web, only to find that the pivot was far from the 3D object itself? Until the last version, you had to manually adjust its position, but now, with the center pivot down command, everything is fixed with just one click, and the object can be modified with extreme ease. 8. Configurations. I saved this feature for the end, both to close the video with a bang, and because it is probably the feature that will revolutionize not only project presentation with Twinmotion, but the entire global rendering. Configurations can finally be exported through cloud project presentation. Now you can send your client a link through which they can not only view the project from any device, but, most importantly, interact with the configurators you have set up in your Twinmotion file, and offer a completely new experience. Soon I will release a new video on my channel where I will discuss specifically the improvements that have been made, so stay tuned! Do you remember the surprise I was talking about at the start of the video? Well, scan the QR code on the screen or click the link in the description to dive into the new era of project presentation. Last but not least, it is crucial to know that this new feature can only be used with the subscription version of Twinmotion. You can find all the pricing information on the official website. Let me know in the comment which of these new features excites you most and what other functionalities you would like to see in the future versions. That said, I wish you a good day or evening and see you very, very soon. Ciao!